Okay, this is another book I've read many times in my life. The copy I had was like an old magazine. This is a new copy. Why Revival Tarries, Leonard Ravenhill. He was born in 1907, died in 1994, and really has made the idea of revival his passion in life, and is like a sort of prophet preaching to the 20th century church about the really stirring up a kind of dissatisfaction with that sort of managed decline and ineffectual nature of church. And it's really, he's really saying throughout this book that the living God of the Bible, who does extraordinary things, who, you know, breathes and the building shakes and tongues of fire and Elisha, Moses, Isaiah, this living God who speaks and acts and history changes, he is still the living God. And that he is not reluctant to act, but we are. So some people say, oh, I don't like that book because it puts all the emphasis on human responsibility and not enough on divine sovereignty. I don't think that's fair at all if you read the book. But the point of the book is not to be some sort of like theological treatise. It's a book that kind of wakes us up and confronts us and stirs us and inspires us. You should definitely read it if you haven't read it. Great thing. Each chapter's quite small, and it begins with kind of challenging, inspiring little quotations at the beginning of each chapter. Here's a good one. Prayer grasps eternity. No man is greater than his prayer life. And then it's got a lot about how you really know a person's spiritual level by the prayer life. They might talk a big game and all the rest of it, but if they're not praying, there's nothing going to come there. There's another great one that I like called Where Are the Elijahs of God? Chapter 4. To the question, where is the Lord God of Elijah? We answer, where he has always been, on the throne. But where are the Elijahs of God? We know Elijah was a man of like passions as we are, but alas, we are not men of like prayer as he was. One praying man stands as a majority with God. And then it talks about how the very obscurity of Elijah was his strength, that he came from nowhere, didn't have anything to trust in. Like, he didn't have any resources or money or anything to trust in. He just prayed. And as James tells us, that's the great feature of him. And it says he lived at a time when, you know, the nation was in tremendous spiritual darkness and decline. How the God of glory had departed. The salt had lost its savor. The gold had become dim. But out of this measureless backsliding, God raised up a man, not a committee, not a sect, not an angel, but a man, and a man of like passions as we are. God sought for a man, not to preach, but to stand in the gap. As Abraham, so now Elijah stood before the Lord. Therefore, the blessed Holy Spirit could write the life of Elijah in two words. He prayed. No man can do more than that for God or for men. If the church today had as many agonizers as she has advisors, we would have revival. There's loads of this book is really about prayer. So why revival tarries, the answer to that question really is, on the basis of this book, is really a combination of the fact that we don't really pray because we don't feel we need to. And also we live very worldly, compromised lives. We are not zealous for the Lord God of Israel. This book will stir you up to pray and to be zealous for the Lord God of Israel. The thing to do is if you read it, only read one chapter. Don't speed read the whole thing. Read one chapter and then get on your knees and pray about it. and let each chapter do its little work within you. Here's a great chapter, Prayer as Vast as God. And that's a great one about getting a big sense of prayer. Like when, you know, we might pray for things like, oh Lord, help me to do my ironing, or can you, you know, find me a car parking spot? Well, I suppose that, you know, if we're anxious about something, pray about it, it's better than not praying at all. But realistically, we need to pray massive prayers that are like biblical prayers that take in the universe and history and nations and zealous for the glory of God and human destiny and all these sorts of things. The potency of prayer, he talks about it here. Holy life, heartbroken mourning, lots in it. Well, anyway, that's this one. It's a roller coaster of a ride, but you can't speed read it. Not if you're going to get the benefit. Why Revival Terrors, Len Raven, has millions of copies of it been produced over the century. So see if you can pick one up.